lessons of standard 6. We are starting with English 2, chapter 2, nouns. What are nouns? Noun is a word which names a person, place, animal, things, objects. Okay, so you can say noun is a naming word. Names a living being, places, animals, things, ideas and feelings. They are naming it. Okay, so we are going to learn about nouns. There are 5 types of nouns. Common noun, proper noun, we have material noun, abstract noun and collective noun. We are starting with common noun. Common noun. Common noun names in general to living beings, places, animals, things, ideas and feelings. It is naming in general. Okay, in our textbook they have mentioned the definition of common noun. Common noun means nouns that name persons, places or objects of the same kind are common noun. Okay, it is naming in general or in common. Let us take an example. Book, pen, pencil, boy, beaver. These are all common noun. In a sentence, let us understand this. I like to eat mangoes. Now here it is not mentioned which mango. It is mentioned mangoes. So this is a common noun. But if name is given to that mango, for example, Kesar mango or maybe Alfonso, then that name would be proper noun. But here only mango is given, so it will be common noun. Second sentence, there is no electricity in this village. Which village? Name is not given. So village is a common noun. But if name is given, Radhapur, Kishan Nagar, something like that, then it will be a proper noun. Got it? So if name is given, then it is proper noun. If it is naming in general or you can say common, then it becomes common noun. Okay. You have to keep this thing in mind that it doesn't start with a capital letter. Okay. For example, mango will not start with a capital letter. Village will not start with a capital letter. But yes, if it is given here Radhanagar, then Radhanagar, R will be capital. So these common noun never starts with a capital letter. Okay. Now let us go through proper noun. What are proper nouns? Proper nouns name specific persons. So they are giving particular name to persons, things, places or any organizations. That is proper noun. Here in the textbook we have the definition. Proper nouns are words which name specific persons, things, places or organization. Now let us take an example. Sachin Tendulkar. Now we know Sachin Tendulkar is a cricketer. So if we use a word cricketer, cricketer is a common noun because name is not given. But if we say Sachin Tendulkar, then it becomes proper noun because the cricketer is given a name, Sachin Tendulkar. Next one, Mumbai. Mumbai is a vast city. City is given a name, Mumbai. So Mumbai becomes a proper noun. But if you say this is a big city, name is not given, so city becomes a common noun. Next one, India. India is a vast country. India is a proper noun. And if it is given that I live in this country, then here in this sentence, country becomes a common noun because name is not given. Okay. Next one, the Times of India. Okay. Name of the newspaper is given, so this becomes a proper noun. Now, let us understand this with a sentence. Ganga is a sacred river. Ganga, name of river is given, so this is proper noun. River becomes a common noun. Next one, Goa is a beautiful state. Name is given of the state, that is Goa, so this becomes a proper noun. And state is a common noun. It is very easy. Okay, what you have to keep in mind, that proper noun always starts with a capital letter. See here, Ganga, G capital, Goa, G capital. Sentence is starting with this only, but then also if the proper noun is coming in between or at the end of the sentence, then also we will start with a capital letter. That you have to keep in mind. Okay, so this is proper noun where specific name is given to these things or places or person. Now let us understand this with a table. Common noun and proper noun. Days, if it is given, then it is a common noun. But name of the days is given, like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, then it becomes a proper noun because days are given a name. Countries, when we talk about, if a word country is given or countries, then it is a common noun because name is not given. But when we talk about India, Japan, America or other countries, when we talk about a particular country, then it becomes a proper noun. River is a common noun, name is not given. But if we say Narmada is a big river of Gujarat, Narmada becomes a proper noun. See carefully, we are writing capitals for these proper nouns, right? And these are not capitals. In the sentence, they will not come in capitals. Boy, boy, which boy? What is the name of the boy? It is not given. This word boy is used commonly. It is used in general. So this is a common name. But if we say Ravi, Ravi becomes a proper noun with a capital letter. Mountain, common noun. If we say Himalaya, Himalaya becomes a proper noun because name of the mountain is given. And the last one, flowers. If we say flower, this is a common noun. These are all in small. But when we see about the name of the flowers, like rose, jasmine, lotus, okay, these are proper noun because they are given a specific particular name. Now students, let us do exercise B, which is given on page number 12. Here the question is, circle the proper nouns and underline the common nouns. Now we are going to do this activity. You have to do this activity in your CW. Okay, so we are not going to circle or underline it. We are going to write like this. Okay, so let us start with first sentence. Rajiv and Priyanka are brother and sister. Now here proper noun is Rajiv and Priyanka, so you will be writing like this: proper noun dash Rajiv, comma Priyanka. What is common noun here in the sentence? Common noun is brother, sister. So write down common noun dash brother, sister. So like this all the sentences will be done. Instead of making it circle and underlining it, you have to write like this. Second sentence, the capital of Nepal is Kathmandu. What is proper noun here? Nepal and Kathmandu. Nepal is the name of country and Kathmandu is the capital. What is the common noun here? It is capital. Third one, Othello was written by William Shakespeare. Okay, proper noun Othello is a name and the name of the author is William Shakespeare. So proper noun is Othello and William Shakespeare. Here in this sentence we do not have a common noun. Okay, so only proper noun you have to write. Next one, fourth, teachers and students work together for the exhibition. Now here, common noun we have, we do not have proper noun in this sentence. Okay, so teachers, because T is capital, from there the sentence is starting. Student and exhibition, they will be starting with the small letter. Fifth one, the poem Ode to Autumn was written by John Keats. Proper noun Ode to Autumn and John Keats, this is the name of the poet. And what is the common noun here? The common noun is poem. What is the name of the poem? Ode to Autumn. Got it? If it is naming, it is a proper noun. If it is not naming, it is given name in general or common, that is common. Next one, Happy Feet is an entertaining movie. The name of the movie is Happy Feet, so that becomes our proper noun. And what is the common noun? Movie. Last one, mother washes Ritu's clothes in the washing machine. Now proper noun Ritu's, you have to take apostrophe s also. Okay, and what is the common noun here? Mother, because it is starting with the godmother, that is the reason it is capital. And clothes, washing machine, these are common noun. This you have to copy in your CW the way I have written on the board. Now let us go through the next noun, that is collective noun. What is collective noun? Collective noun means nouns that name a group or a class of similar things or person taken together and spoken of as one whole are called collective nouns. It means it is a group of similar things. Okay, It's a name of a collection of things, that is collective noun. And it is a singular noun. It is never a plural noun, that you have to remember. And they are used as common noun. They are not proper noun. They name the group, so they are common noun. Example: army, herd, fleet, bunch, and pack. A group of soldiers is known as army. Okay. A group of elephants and sheep is known as herd. It means every word has a different collective noun. A group of ships, that will be called as fleet and not herd. And large group of cars, that is also known as fleet. A large group of banana. If you see many bananas, you have to say bunch instead of many bananas. Okay. And if you see a lot of flowers, group of flowers. So it is never said group of flowers. It is said bunch of flowers. Okay. And for dogs, we use a word pack. That is the collective noun. And for wolves also, we use pack. Okay. You cannot use bunch for dogs and bunch for wolves, or pack of bananas and pack of flowers. So for every word, you have to keep in mind the collective nouns are different, and it can be same for others also. For example, fleet can be used for ships also and cars also. Okay, but you cannot interchange with the other nouns. Okay, now let us take example in the sentence. These are not given in the textbook. Many dogs were chasing a monkey. Now, if you say many dogs, what is the collective noun for many dogs? It is pack. So the right sentence would be the pack of dogs was. Why was? Because we have learned here that it is a singular noun. Okay, so singular noun. So here it will be was instead of were. A pack of dogs was chasing a monkey. Next one. A large group of bees were hovering near the hive. What do you mean by a large group of bees? Large group of bees means a swarm. This is the collective noun for bees. So you have to say it like this. A swarm of bees was, because it is a singular noun, hovering near. Now let us go through a set of collective nouns which is given on page number 12. Okay, let us discuss few of them. They have given us 18. Second one. A suite of room. What is a suite of room? A set of rooms. Okay. Then fifth one. A swarm of bees. What do you mean by swarm? A large group of flying insects. Okay. It may be bees or any other insect. Then we use the word swarm as a collective noun. Then eighth one. A mob of people. Okay. What do you mean by mob? Mob is a group of people. Those who are creating violence. Okay, who are, you know, creating so much of disturbance in the city. Those are known as a mob of people. Then, ninth one, a flock of birds. The birds which are flying together, for them we use the word flock. Tenth one, a bunches of bananas, grapes and flowers. Okay, for these three we use a collective noun, bunch. Then, 14th one, a clump of trees. What do you mean by a clump? Clump means the trees which are growing in large number and growing closer to each other. That is clump. That is the collective noun for the trees. 20th one, a shoal of fish. What do you mean by a shoal of fish? A shoal means a group of, a shoal means a collective noun used for the fish which are swimming together. Okay. So group of fish is known as shoal. And the 18th one, we have a library of books. When we have a lot of books, we call it as a library. That is the collective noun for a large number of books. So we have all of them, and you have to write in your CW. Just write one times, but learn it carefully. Okay. Now then we have exercise number C. Match the words in column A with appropriate words in column B. So instead of matching, we'll be writing it like this. So it becomes very easy for us to learn also. So first one is a fleet. A fleet is used for a set of luxury cars. Okay. Then second one, an orchard. Orchard of fruit trees. A crowd of people. Fourth one, an army of soldiers. Okay, for soldiers we use collective noun army. A library of books. We have just discussed. Okay, and the sixth one, a suite of rooms. When there are a large number of rooms, like in hotels, okay, we use the word suite. Okay, and here are some extra collective nouns. These are not given in our textbook, but let us discuss and learn it. A dash of directors. What do you call a group of directors? We called it as a board. Board of directors. Okay. Second one, a dash of ants. What do you call a group of ants? We call it as colony. A colony of ants. When you see a lot of ants, we say colony of ants. Third one, a dash of lions. When you see many lions together, we call it as pride of lions. Now see, these are collective nouns and we are writing small letters for it, okay, because they are singular nouns. Okay, and fourth one, a dash of beads. For beads we use a word collective noun, that is string. Okay, these are extra, these are not even